Hey, it's Troy DeGroat. Thanks for checking out my channel, Bluebeam and Burgers. I've got lots of videos with tips and tricks planned out, so make sure you like, subscribe, and click the bell to be notified when I publish those. Today, I just want to go over flipbooks and how to add images to your PDF drawings. To start out, I'm just going to go with a simple one here. Go to Tools, Markups, go down here to Image. Now this isn't the flipbook yet, but this is just going to add an image from file. I can go out to my folder where I have my images saved. This one in particular is from Google Earth. And then you just come in here and click and drag to place that on your sheet. Now I don't typically like this tool just because when I've done site visits in the past, there's only so many pictures you can put on your drawings before you start to cover up what's on part of the drawing. So there's another tool, the Flipbook, that I'll show you in a second, but I just wanted to show you this. There are some workflows that we've helped customers with, particularly going out and getting images from Google Earth. So you can get the site, go out, and we're just going to select that image, go over to our properties, the little gearbox over here, and we're going to reduce the opacity. So I'm just going to bump that down, and you'll notice as I bump that down, you can start to see the drawing through there. So showing a lot of customers how to use this for site logistics. A lot of times they'll bring in an image from Google Earth, like I said, and overlay it on a civil site plan. And then we can also build some custom tools for trailers and outhouses and all sorts of different equipment that you'd have on the site. You can lay those out and move them around as the site changes. So that's one tool for adding an image. What I want to show you today though is the flipbook. So I'm going to go little icon here. I've got images attached to this note. So just have a common Cloud Plus note image. I'm going to click on that and it'll open a flipbook for us. And you can see the image that I attached to that markup. So you can attach an image to any markup, whether it's a line, Cloud Plus, call out, even a symbol like this one. You simply just click on that markup after you place it, right click, go to capture. And if you're in the field, you can go from camera, or what I'm gonna do is from file. So I can just select that and go to where I have those images saved. And with my control or shift key, I can select as many as I want. So I'm just going to go in with my control key and select several here. And I'm going to click open. And that icon is going to show up. So that indicates I have an image. And when I click on that, it's going to open the flipbook again and show me those images. So when I open my flipbook, I got some tools across the bottom here. The first one here is to take another picture. So that's when you're in the field. You can take a picture again. It's going to add it to this flipbook on that symbol. The next one is from file. So you're going to add another photo from a file. And then we've got arrows in here. So the arrows are going to allow us to flip through the images that we attached to that markup. Okay. Here in the middle, the name here, I can double click this and rename that image if I want to while it's in my file. Some other buttons here, I can export these images as well, either the current image or all of them. And then of course the trash can is to delete those. So just a few tools within that flipbook, and you'll see that when I click out of it, again, it goes back to that icon and it indicates there's images, but it doesn't take up the whole sheet. So it's really nice to add those images, really as many as you want. You know, it's going to add to the file size, of course, but I'll put a link in the description below for a tip there on if you've got a ton of pictures. I did a blog post a while ago about adding those images to Google Photos and then linking them to the symbol rather than importing all those images. Okay. That's another blog post. Well, again, we'll put the link in the description. So some other things that I wanted to show you just in relation to adding images is some tips and tricks here. So whether you're adding your images to a note indicating what's going on or a symbol, or maybe you could even go into building some custom tools. So I was just having fun one day, I created a camera. So I could place that in a room and attach images to that. Or maybe I've got a video. I can place that in a room. We can also add 360-degree images. So I can add those symbols. I just built those custom tools, just having fun. So you can do that. Add those images in there, and then you'll know exactly what type of photo that you're going to be looking at or video. I've also seen symbols where it's just a simple sequence and maybe an arrow that points in the direction that they're taking the photo. Makes sense. If you're pointing at certain walls or corners or things like that. Okay, another thing that I want to show here is another tip is in this particular case, I created spaces. So here you can see I've got spaces or indicated for each room. I'll do another video on spaces just to kind of elaborate on that. But basically, you just trace the area and you give it a name. So I named it room 1259. So you'll see that in the list here. And what that does is when I place a symbol and I add an image to it, down here in my markups list, I have spaces as a category. And when you look at that, I can now sort this list by just clicking on the header of that column, and it's going to show me all of the markups that I have in room 1256 and all of the data that comes with it. So very useful if you're doing punch walks or things like that. You can add a space, create those. I'll also do another video. You can have those come over directly from Revit. The area measurements, the rooms in Revit will convert to spaces if you have your settings right. So look for another video on that. With the 360 degree image, I'll show you that again. I've got a video already. I'll put a link to that one on how to add those and kind of the possibilities there. I'll just show that real quick here. We can add a 360 degree photo and go in here and see all of that information that we wouldn't typically take a note of or take a picture of. We can go back almost as if we're on site and see that information again. And the last thing I want to show you is a tip here, kind of a workaround, I guess. I hate to call it that because it's actually a really, really nice feature. This icon here is not going to show up with other PDF viewers. And so if you're sharing these with somebody that doesn't have Bluebeam, they're not going to be able to see this icon and click to see those images. However, there's a workflow where I can come down to my markups list, and I'm just going to filter some of these out so that our list isn't so long. I'm going to click here, and maybe I'll just look at my mechanical markups. Okay, everything grayed out up here that's not mechanical. I can still see my notes and things like that for my mechanical. Okay, so the workflow, I'm just going to go into this summary here, go to PDF summary, and my dialog comes up. I'm just going to go ahead and load my Bluebeam and Burgers letterhead to show you that you can do that. Just create a PDF letterhead, import it, and you'll be able to set that as your standard for all your summaries that you create. Okay, I'm going to append and hyperlink to the current PDF. So my report is going to be part of this file with the drawing. And then down here in the options, I'm going to click there and include capture media addendum and attach the media as linked files. I'm going to say OK there. And then I'm just going to click OK. It's going to take a second to run through and run this report. I'll minimize my markups list here, and you can see I've got a report of each of those markups, each of those symbols, what it means, all the data that's in the custom columns down below in your markups list, tells you what room it's in, and it gives you this little thumbnail so you can see where that's at in the drawing. If I click on that, it's going to bring me directly to that place in my drawing. So very nice feature there. If I go back to my report, you'll see it's added in my thumbnails. You can see it's added to that file. And if I go all the way to the bottom, the last page is going to be a capture media summary where it puts your image. Now, I say that's a workaround, but it's really nice because At this point, the PDF is a container holding this image. So I can click on here and open or download and save these. So I don't have to worry about whether I emailed the photos or if the photos are too big or anything like that to the customer. I can simply just run this report and email this PDF of the drawing with the report attached, and all of these images are going to be embedded and transferred to them as well. Just some quick tips in there and how the Flipbook works and how some different ways that you can add images to your PDF drawings. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. Otherwise, again, subscribe, like, hit the bell to be notified of my next videos. Thanks for watching.